between the Tigers of Missouri and the Purple Aces of Evansville. I'm Gene Davis, your public address announcer. Presenting the traditional flower lays to the players, the Maui greeting of aloha is the lovely Terry Lynn Myatt, 1988 Mrs. Hawaii. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for Missouri, utilizing a three-guard, two-forward alignment. At forward, a 6'9" senior from Detroit, Michigan, number 22, Nathan Bunting. Also at forward, a 6'10" junior from Detroit, number 34, Doug Smith. At guard, a 6'1" senior from Detroit, number 4, Lee Coward. At guard, a 6'5" sophomore from Detroit, number 23, Jamal Coleman. And at the other guard, a 6'4" sophomore from Kansas City, Missouri, number 44, Anthony Keeler. And the head coach of the Missouri Tigers, Norm Stewart. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for Evansville. At forward, a 6'9" junior from Lafayette, Indiana, number 33, Mark Jewell. At forward, a 6'7" senior from Baltimore, Maryland, number 42, Brian Hill. At center, a 6'9" senior from Stillman Valley, Illinois, number 53, Dan Gottfried. At guard, a 6'1" sophomore from Stoneport, Illinois, number 20, Scott Scheffler. And at the other guard, a 6'5" sophomore from Cincinnati, Ohio, number 34, Chris Mack. And the head coach of the Purple Aces, Jim Cruz.
And the career record of Jim Cruz, very effective, going into his fifth season as the coach of the Evansville Purple Aces. And take a look at a little background on both of these clubs as we come into tonight's game. For Missouri, of course, a couple of kids who are now playing in the NBA, Byron Irvin and Gary Leonard. Irvin with Houston, Gary Leonard playing with the Minnesota club, but it's been a great 80s for the Tigers.
Not a bad duo. Byron Irvin could fill it up, and of course, Leonard, great inside post moves. And of course, you saw Scott Hefner, too, who's down in Miami with the Heat.
That's right, a lot of points gone for Evansville. Jim Cruz, perfect in opening games. Let's see what happens tonight. And there's Norm Stewart, a guy who is very happy to be here.
And showing it, he's really having a ball.
Yes, he is.
In good health and ready to roll.
Gottfried and Smith will go up in the middle.
Baggy Paparo running the TV end of things now, moving cameras with Montanato, another official.
We're underway. Evansville controls the tap, and quickly it's Scheffler into the forecourt. Coward awaits him there. Smith out on Jewell. Inside, good move, Gottfried. He got fouled from behind by Button. Is it Button or is it a reach-in? Might have been Keeler.
Yeah, may have been Anthony Keeler on the double up down low. You may have seen the crispness of the cuts, reminiscent of the Indiana Hoosiers. That ability to screen and keep your man in motion. Jimmy Cruz, of course, learned from the master, Robert Knight.
Great numbers for Dan Gottfried last year. 11th in the country in block shots.
What I liked last year when I saw him is his toughness, you know, mental as well as physical. I mean, he just hangs tough, really pursues the game.
Bunton takes down the rebound. Here come the Tigers' first trip in the offense. Lee Coward will run the show.
McIntyre outside, good outside shooter, too.
And that's a travel. Bunton lost his footing down the baseline.
Nothing more than some perspiration, a lot of that. And a man fault. interesting how they forced the big guy to bring it up.
Jewel didn't do a bad job there.
No, I wouldn't want him to do it all night, if I was Jimmy.
Jewel again up high. Back looking inside. That's Traveler, took a big step.
Yeah, sliding to space, caught between making a post pass and looking for the dribble or shot.
Back quickly, Peeler down the baseline, pull up left-handers, an air ball, and Jewel clears. Evansville tough early on the boards.
He's got Treffler, a real factor offensively. They can dump it back out to him.
Here's Mack looking to penetrate. Nowhere to go, nearly lost it, Treffler.
And those lead Cowher really staying at home on Scott Treffler. When the ball goes inside, he's not going to help.
Gottfried outside, no, tipped over the top. Jewel got a hand on it, Missouri ball. Doug Smith, a lot of pro scouts here to look at number 34 for Missouri.
Straight up man.
McIntyre gives it up. Howard had a great season last year. Can really shoot the three, set a Missouri record for three-point shots.
Pretty good defensive set right now, sliding the picks.
Mueller can't penetrate. McIntyre will try, and he buries it outside.
Catholic Central. Tom Lagarde, who played at Carolina. Tom Zalagaris. Pretty good basketball program. Nice.
Jewel. No tip. Yes, Godfrey.
Nice soft delivery by Jewel. Of course, he drew some attention. Left Godfrey all alone.
Button a little trouble with the handle. They caught a break though. Peeler can't get it down. One and you're done so far.
Very sound, aren't they?
Yep.
Checking out. I wonder where he learned all of that.
They probably know they better check
out. Oh.
In there. Back door was open.
What a pick by Godfrey. Nice pass, but excellent pick. And Jewel, the beneficiary.
5-2 Evansville, and Evansville has a heck of a rooting section here. A lot of people made the trip. McIntyre hits again outside, giving three.
That's good to see. Last year I had a couple of their games, and he didn't really have the confidence. Plus now he's going to get the minutes with Sam Bodie and Church gone. Two terrific players for Norm Stewart last year. Not to say anything about Byron Irvin outside. Change of possession gives Missouri the basketball. Did you see Peeler last year at all, Mike?
Not at all.
Oh, my goodness. He can really do some exciting things.
Everybody tells me he'll light it up once or twice this weekend before it's through.
Strong enough to go inside, yet is a perimeter player. Exciting.
Back door play. Peeler.
Brian Hill just turned his head, lost eye contact with the basketball.
Mack lane to the hoop, taken away, foul. McIntyre got him.
But he may have walked before, Mike. Lost the dribble high. A break for Evansville. McIntyre talking to Norm Stewart there. You got to think he's really enjoying his trip. This is one where I thought if they just let him go, McIntyre really didn't have to help. I think he was going to walk with the basketball. But Norm got a chance to play a little golf. He looks great. Excited about his team as well. Because Rich Daly, great to have good assistants.
Yes,
I should know. We'd win many, but without Hadi Mahana was with me, I could have packed the tack early. But Rich Daly, coach, took over, really held the troops together last year.
Godfrey is stripped. Peeler the other way. Foul on Hill as he bumped him outside. First on Brian Hill, 7-6 Missouri, as we look at Norm Stewart.
He's been over here enough to know how to dress.
Missouri 12-3 overall in Hawaii. We've made quite a few trips out here.
Tough, huh? Not a bad gamble out by Coward. Norm Stewart told Will Belke, our producer, that if you can't have fun over here, you're weird. I guess we're not weird, Mike.
Managing to do it. Coward hits from the corner.
for three. You got to think Reed Crafton, who really was a good player last year, and Jim Crews just not feeling comfortable with him. They miss him, but I guess for the long road, Jim Crews knows it's better for his program.
Outside, Schreffler wild with the jumper. Oof. Good hustle by Gottfried, though, to pick it up after Peeler and Hill with that. Inside Gottfried, quick turnaround. Smith.
Major league rebound.
Sure was. McIntyre on a wing. Smith really getting the handle of the ball first time in the offensive end. Fires away. Mack is there for the rebound.
Not a good one.
No, it wasn't.
Good play.
Back door was open again.
Again, Gottfried with a marvelous roadblock. Both of us could have gotten free on that one. Mack the beneficiary again.
Tigers by two. And again, if you missed the earlier game, it's very hot in this building. No air conditioning. Very hot day. McIntyre. Oh, as the shooter's bounced for three.
Well, he drilled two, and Mack went and helped out. Chris Mack went to double up. I don't think he can leave McIntyre alone. Proves some Irish guys can shoot.
Picked off inside. Bunton heading the other way. Loops it across to McIntyre. Didn't think he'd find him, but he did. And John McIntyre's really having himself a half here. He's got 10 of the 15, 6 minutes into the game.
When Evansville runs their stuff, they shoot in a hurry. Now, that's a good play. They took advantage of the little trap outside. When they run their stuff, they get easy baskets.
Five for Dan Gottfried.
Well, they're giving McIntyre that shot. Chris Mack in a one-man zone.
Here he is again, top of the key, passes it up, looks for Bunton on the cut.
Oh, boy, the confidence should be soaring right now. John McIntyre, he should take that jumper.
You ever going to take it, John? Drill that one. 15-10. 5-point Missouri lead.
Now, hundreds in cashbacks, low finance rates, two doors, four doors, all from Chevrolet. Up to $1,000 cashback or 6.9% financing can be yours. Up to $1,000 cashback on our popular Corsicas. Up to $800 on the sleek Chevy Beretta. You can even get up to $750 and the new 1990 Lumina sedan now. So see your Chevrolet dealer today. For more ways to get great deals, nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Now, almost every time you use MasterCard before December 31st, you increase your chances of winning your MasterCard bills paid up to $18,000 a year till the 21st century. MasterCard. Master the moment until the 21st century.
Hit it, boys!
Isn't there someone you know who could use a skill twist this Christmas? The skill twist. The practical gift for practically anybody.
Engines designed to aerospace tolerances should have a fuel that's equally exacting. Because the more sophisticated the engine, the more sophisticated the fuel must be. Exxon Gasolines, precision equipment for precision engines. Just turn the key.
The good times continue here in Maui. 15-10 Missouri up by five in the final game of the day. Villanova Wildcats, North Carolina, Louisville all have advanced. John McIntyre's had a hot hand, but passed up a great opportunity here.
John, you've got to nail this. Maybe one bounce to the stripe and drill it. Here the over-penetration, and he is on the board, and the confidence should be soaring. Number 34, Chris Mack, a one-man zone, and McIntyre has been killing them.
Milt Donald has checked into the lineup first time for Evansville. There you see Missouri with a perfect record with the threes. Travis Ford making his first appearance. 5'10 freshman who I know you like from Missouri.
I've enjoyed him. In fact, I got to meet his dad. And I remember him some of the All-Star games at high school. Great shooter and a good floor general as well.
This is Donald. 6'4 senior. Underneath Garth Reed. Bunton's got him. Garth Reed wants to go. Bunton, good job shutting him off. Mack, 4'3.
Within the system. That very patient. Active off the basketball as well.
Evansville 13th in the country in three-point shooting rather last year, 44%. Inside Peeler trying to get loose. Godfrey initially got a piece of it, and we got a foul on Button off the ball.
A little bit of a shove. Anthony Peeler trying to get involved in the game. May have rushed that one a little bit, but that's proof that he can go down inside and hold off. And as you noted, see the help though, the good reaction. Help your partner type of defense. And Button didn't have to shove.
Little nudge
the smaller Chris Mack, but then
Schreffler, tough shot. Ripped off underneath there. Smith's rebound's a big one when he pulls it down. Mack the quick hands, but a kick is called.
Didn't even want to move there.
Missouri will push that ball, take a good opportunity break, good team speed.
Here's a look at Travis Ford, 5'10 freshman guard.
He can shoot this too. They're going to give him that. He'll get it once he gets warmed up.
Inside, Doug Smith trying to get going.
Got away with a push too, Mike.
Hill slows down the break. Mack will reset. I tell you, nobody on Evansville stands around in the offensive end, do they?
Keeps the defense thinking. You've got to react to the cut or pay for it.
Godfrey high.
I used to remember playing this ocean type of team when I was a kid, where they exhausted you.
Godfrey, and that's a goaltender. Smith got there late.
A message of reject. You'll think a little bit when Doug's around. That's true.
7 points for Dan Godfrey.
Defense, you talk about ability, God-given, but you've got to react and see things, and that certainly will get your attention.
Here's Ford outside. Mack got a piece of it. Loose ball. Good save underneath. Excellent play by Doug Smith there.
Well, they know that Ford can shoot the basketball. Now he's got to put it on the floor. He's got the guy reacting as Chris Mack got a piece.
Mark Jewell's going to come back in. Brian Hill will get arrested. Peeler looking to inbound. Tied at 15 here. Evansville on a 5-point run. Peeler quiet so far.
Mm-hmm. Very much so.
So is Cowards, for that matter. Hit 1-3 from the corner.
He's only shooting quickly, though. I think that's part of the problem. Whoops.
There's good fall.
Alert. That pressure pretty good.
Jewel inside. Godfrey's turnaround will go long. Kick Mack twice, won't go. Over the top, we got the foul. Smith the Button, which one?
Well, all of them attack. Initially, Evansville initiated some contact, but good aggressive basketball pursuing the ball.
We've got a timeout. 17-15, Missouri's lead down to 2.
Indianapolis Motor Speedway, and Chevy does what's never been done before. Not with a race car, not even a car, but with a new full-size Chevy Sport truck. Chevy averages over 100 miles an hour for 24 straight hours at Indy to win the prestigious Hallman Indy Challenge Trophy. Chevrolet, so far ahead, even our trucks are winning at Indy. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Coast to coast, we really know our customers, and our customers know us. We're friends.
Save during our Christmas sale on Hoover's Elite Upright Vacuum with 5-piece tool set, only $79.99. Buy the Dustbuster Cordless Handbag, only $22.88. Or Black & Decker's Handy Chop Mincer Chopper, only $19.99. At your local Coast to Coast and Home and Auto store.
Coast to coast, home and auto.
ESPN gives you a spectacular courtside view of ACC and Big East basketball, slam-jammed with color and excitement. Check out the sparkling sights and sounds of the electrifying shootouts all season long. What a pass!
Get a T.O., baby!
Go get him, big fella! Rock and roll!
nation's top conferences battle in nightly doubleheaders during the first ever ACC Big East Challenge Week, starting Monday, December 4th, live on ESPN.
...17-15 Missouri by two with 11.5 to go here. First half, final game of the day here from Maui. And this is like a convention of the winningest coaches, active coaches in college basketball right now. Dean Smith and Lefty Drysdale, of course, had a memorable game here earlier today. And look at Norm Stewart.
Uh-huh.
Right there at 5:26.
Now, Michael, I've watched Smith, Haskins, Drysdale, and Tarkanian. I didn't play Henson, so you can't throw that at me. But
Wanted to, though, right?
They all wanted me. The Lou Dew, he wanted to do it to me. But all of those people have stood the test of time. A lot of back screens.
Milt Darnold, Scott Schreffler, Chris Mack, Brian Hill, Mark Jewell on the floor right now for the Evansville Purple Aces.
Hill did a good job holding off on Doug Smith.
Inside, Hill's turnaround.
Well, now you may not see Doug Smith fighting as hard with Hill's release that time. Get back off, let him take it.
Howard looks to set the offense. Smith comes high.
First, last year, Hill had 21 points, I believe, against Oregon State in the NCAA. So just an error. Nice
backdoor Coward. Missed the layup.
Good look by Nathan Button as
well.
Yes,
sure was. Mack.
Oh.
Momentary daylight.
Mark Jewell headhunting. Switching inside now, either tired or dictated by a good pick.
Schreffler finally with some room. Mack trying to keep it alive. Hill does, and a foul on Smith as he got ball, but he got Hill at the same time.
Michael, Jimmy Cruz is really competitive. I mean, he's a terrific assistant under Bobby Knight. His club, an extension of him, how they go after things. And they're not the biggest, not the quickest jumping team, but they are competing with some major league people on the Missouri team.
Jeff Warren makes his first appearance of the game. Smith's going to sit down with those two fouls. Coward also sitting down. McIntyre back in.
Jeff Warren, not a bad prospect, according to Missouri people. Looked pretty good in his workout that I saw. Some good young people.
And Brian Hill, 6'7", senior out of Baltimore at the line. Chance to get his club back into a tie here.
At a Dunbar. Bob Wade's old high school.
They can produce him. Evansville ultimately losing in the NCAAs last year to Seton Hall. Heck of a basketball team, if I remember
right.
They
sure did. Now, they say Jimmy Cruz could run for mayor and win, and nobody would go against him. So he's really turned the city into that Arab McCutcheon era.
Great basketball tradition at that school. Button really took it into some heavy traffic, but he got a foul out of it. Godfrey, I believe, picking up his first.
Hey, he was in pretty good position. He must have reached down.
We're going to give it to Jewell. Only two fouls on Evansville in 11 minutes. And they've been aggressive.
Are you sane?
No, I think that's a credit to Jimmy Cruz. He gets them to play tough, but they play fair.
Well, they're in good position, so you won't foul as much.
Mack comes back in. Schreffler goes out.
Jimmy Cruz can't believe it's a shooting foul.
10 minutes into the game, first opportunity for Missouri at the line.
Can't blame them either on that particular play.
Nathan was making that one up as he went along.
Full court pressure now.
First point for Bunt. 2-point Missouri lead. Donald brings it up successfully against Ford.
Godfrey's not afraid to mix it up. He initiates the contact, and then they whack him. He sort of gets away with it.
Alley-oop to Hill. That's not going to work.
It was there for a second, and then Chris Mack saw it. It was a little bit late. Good idea.
Anthony Peeler able to break it up.
A
Two looking and finding Hill, gets the bump. Oh, traveling is called. Basket went down too. Brian Hill thought he had himself a three-point play when he heard the whistle.
I'm with you, Brian. A little mystery.
Ford and McIntyre, the Missouri backcourt. Beal again unable to get anything on. Ford open for a moment.
Chris Mack's a little bit of a woofer. He's talking to Travis Ford.
Near steal, and Hill and Peeler chase it. Evansville ball.
Gotta catch it. Anthony sort of moving before he got the basketball.
Anthony Peeler doesn't seem to have any rhythm in this game.
He's not getting that fast break going where he can really go to the goal and get the adrenaline pumping. Great slam dunk artist.
Mack wide open for three and knocks it down.
Great acknowledgement too. They don't waste any time. Snap pass. Give the guy time. Peterson.
Purple Aces with the lead. It's one. Travis Ford.
They got McIntyre.
You bet. Second foul on John McIntyre.
Good to see Dick Paparo, one of the great sprinters from half court, when he has the call right on top of it.
Don't get in his way.
I had a couple of kids out of Catholic Central, John McIntyre's school, and they really were well coached. Holowicki, I believe, was the coach. Bernie Holowicki. Chris Rozanka, big kid we had, and it's a terrific program.
Donald will move, now gives it up to Mack.
Good hands here.
Ford nearly got it.
Pretty good double and reaction by Button in the back.
And now we got Travis Ford off the ball, holding.
Travis' dad takes kids to Europe at high school teams. Used to be a high school coach and was talking to me about his son, how well he played in the All-Star games, and I just got a bang out of watching him shoot the ball and run the team. I think they've got a great leader to step in when Lee Coward moves on.
Milt Donald's going to step up to the stripe, 6'4 senior from Cincinnati. Getting a lot of minutes here in the first half. Evansville by 1:08:10 to play here first half. McIntyre had a hot hand early. Peeler yet to get really involved, looking for a shot. Forced one.
Oof.
McIntyre, good hustle play for the rebound. Keeps going baseline. Hey!
Pretty play. I thought he had the jumper. When you can shoot as well as he does, I'd settle for that jumper instead of getting in there with the big people.
He's got 12 of Missouri's 20.
Mix up.
Peeler comes down with the air ball. Now Peeler looking to show his stuff himself in the middle. Ford squares up. Still won't go down for him, and Mack is there weak side.
Injured player. It's Brian Hill.
Dick Paparo with a quick stoppage of play, and now Schreffler will come back in. And we're going to get a timeout. 7:28 to go here first half. Missouri by one.
Choice of a personal spa is an investment in yourself and your future. With a Morgan Spa, you can enjoy quality craftsmanship for many years to come. Morgan Buildings and Spas is having a spectacular 5-day sale. Save up to 35% off with no down payment. Financing is also available to qualified buyers. All spas include all chemicals, a tapered cover to retain heat and protect it from the elements, and up to a 10-year warranty on selected models. Lay away a therapeutic Morgan Spa now at Morgan Buildings and Spas, 1201 Covert Avenue at Highway 41.
Does Crazy Larry's waterbeds and turkeys have in common? Absolutely nothing! Except the first semi-annual Turkey Day sale. We're shooting holes at high prices on all sheets, pillowcases, comforters, soft-sided waveless waterbeds. Everything else at the store is drastically reduced. We'll beat or match any price in town, and we're not just pulling your drumstick. As part of our first semi-annual Turkey Day sale, purchase any waterbed and receive a set of drawers absolutely free. Not those kind. So don't be a featherhead. Come to Crazy Larry's waterbeds for holiday savings with all the trimmings. And hurry, because time's a-bastin'.
the same.
All week long, Mike Ryan is a buttoned-up, by-the-numbers, straight-ahead type of guy. But on the weekend, Mike likes to get into his Quad 4 Chevy Beretta GTZ, find a twisty road, and put it all behind him. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. That's the day to Chevrolet.
Both clubs are struggling in their shooting, but they are able to get free and maybe rush shots on occasion. Missouri holding that 1-point lead. But in order to tire people out, keep them active, have them peeking, you must continue to move your man. You see a nice pick by Jewell. Nice open shot. Normally, that's a deuce, and Jimmy Crews not getting the reaction he wanted.
As you mentioned, neither club really able to get into any kind of offensive rhythm here, 42% and 44%. That's not to take away from the defenses, but quite a few open shots and not going down. Schreffler now running the show. The freshman 40 goes by him, and that's going to be a foul on Gottfried, who nailed it.
Well, he got away with one earlier, Mike. Anytime you extend the arm, and I notice you haven't extended it very much here in Maui to pick anything up, you're going to get called by the official.
I usually get called by you. 7:15 to go first half. You can see Jimmy Crews very much agreed with that call. Jamal Coleman has checked into the game. Outside, won't get out for Bunton, and that's the way it's been going. Brian Hill with the rebound. McIntyre, the hot early hand. Mac with the ball, has hit a couple of threes, takes this one inside, leans. Tried to get the contact, followed his shot. And it might have cost him. Yep.
He did. Pretty little pump fake. Got himself into that 3-second area and just couldn't hang enough to complete it. But that pump fake is something that Bobby Knight teaches at Clint. Pump it, gets the guy towards you or up in the air. That particular time, Chris just couldn't hang on long enough.
He goes straight up, he maybe makes that.
Yes.
Tried to lean in and get some contact. McIntyre, Coleman, Ford. Jim Horton making his first appearance in the game, along with Warren.
They feel he's a good player. He's going to be a good performer. A little bit like Gary Leonard, who got better each year. Good inside moves.
McIntyre keeps going. Blocked from behind, picked off by Hill. Schreffler thought about it.
Pretty dish. See the kids look down for the three-point line. We used to look at down for the out of bounds line.
McIntyre kicked it out of bounds for the Evansville ball. 6:18 to play in the first half. Missouri by one. Norm Sloan really getting a good look at his club. Jim Crews down there on the Evansville bench has gone about 7 or 8 in. Norm Sloan's already 10 into that bench. Norm Stewart, excuse me.
That's a normal Stormin' Norman, they call him too. A faux pas.
Schreffler outside. Still won't fall for him.
Stepping into the shooting area, just can't knock it down. Last year, 49% too.
Horton now looks to get something set. Ford will call the offense.
You notice how a lot of teams use the center to reverse the ball? A lot more than they used to.
Jamal Coleman, tough shot.
And Jamal thrusting the fist. Should have got me in earlier, Norm. Great angle pass.
Gottfried.
Chris Mack just saw the right hand, dropped it baseline, and led Gottfried right to the goal.
He's got 9. Ford looking to go.
Pretty good D there by Schreffler.
Excellent defense. Warren can't hit outside. Mack takes the rebound over the top from McIntyre.
Almost took McIntyre's uniform,
sure
too.
Sure did. Inside again, Gottfried leaves it for Jewell. Little left-handed air ball.
Ooh.
Here comes Ford. Mark Jewell did not look comfortable putting
that
one up.
No, that didn't look like a beautiful release.
Coleman.
Similar to that one.
Yep. Mack was right in his face.
Right now, a lot of condominiums being built, huh?
Hill will pull it back out. Mack wants it. And it's going to be Hill over the top with the foul. Second on Brian Hill.
Those rims should be loose by now. A lot of basketball all day long.
It sure has.
I can't get over the end of that Carolina-James Madison game. Like, some of the viewers may not have seen it, but without timeouts left and a violation on the end line, and all of a sudden King Rice dribbles, nails it off the glass.
Off the glass. Yeah.
He said he didn't call it. Little help.
And North Carolina winning.
Sutton in. Go up, out of bounds, Missouri ball.
See, Peeler can take most little people into that box and be devastating. Norm Stewart obviously going to go with a lot of three-guard play with McIntyre as a starter, then bring Travis Ford in with Coward and Peeler as well.
That's what Lee Coward does best. Four minutes to go now, first half, three-point game. Neither team really able to crank it up offensively, running the patterns, the shot's not going down. Donald's got some room, takes a strong offensive foul, too strong.
Good call. I mean, if I'm on Norm Stewart's bench, I'm upset, but pretty darn good seal at the baseline. I should say, Jim Kerr's bench. Gotta be happy about Norm Stewart.
We got a timeout with 3:49 left to go here in the first half. Missouri still up, the lead is three.
Getting to know.
In the 80s, Honda became known for its reliable, feature-filled cars.
You ready, Dad?
I love this car.
But today, the 90s begin with the new Geo Prism. The quality sedan with 16-valve performance, Prism is designed for years of carefree driving with more of the features and little extras that make life easier. So you know you'll be friends for a long time. Get to know the new Geo Prism at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Getting to know you.
Panasonic presents the Smooth Operators. The Smooth Operators are cordless rechargeable razors that shave remarkably close, either wet or dry. It takes a Smooth Operator to unite the old-fashioned closeness of a warm, wet shave with the convenience and no-nick comfort of an electric. Don't try this with any plugged-in razor. Smooth Operator wet-dry razors from Panasonic. Smoother than you ever thought you'd be.
Dickies takes you back through the ages to show you a few of the famous people who've worn Dickies pants. Your dad. General George Armstrong Custer. Abraham Lincoln. Blackbeard the Pirate. William Shakespeare. Robin Hood. Attila the Hun. You too can wear these famous pants by Dickies. Available every day at famous low prices. Dickies, famous since 1922. Attila the Hun, made with Forshaw polyester by Fiber Industries.
24-21, Missouri by three. 3:49 to go here, first half, our final game from Maui.
Well, Michael, you gotta love to make the pass. Now watch Chris, he bends, that's a lot of effort. He wants to get it to the post. Puts it to the correct hand, the outside hand. Now this leads the drop step to the basket for Dan Gottfried. So just a normal type of play, but you gotta want it to get to your big guy.
Lee Coward with five here in the first half. Missouri, 10th straight winning season. 10th and 11th in most of the polls, right in that neighborhood, the preseason poll. It's the deep team, obviously, that Norm Stewart has, as he's gone 10 in already.
I'm sure Missouri people are saying, what's going on here? But it's so early in the year. Everybody feeling one of that. North Carolina didn't play well in the first half at all. It's just a process where the kids are getting the kinks out. And Sutton delivers, huh?
Brad Sutton, 6'9", senior, knocking it down. Stretches the lead to five.
Chris Mack likes to pick people hard. He and Gottfried must have fun.
Good on pick. Good luck, and he found him.
Anytime you pick, he caused that confusion. Mack worked himself into a goal.
Mack and Gottfried with 20 of the 23 for Evansville. Sutton looking inside, nobody home.
Remember earlier we talked about the center out there reversing the ball? That's the downside. I mean, they may drop kick it on occasion out there as Sutton made that tough turnover.
Chris Heller, a 6'10 freshman, is coming to the lineup now for Missouri. Here's a look at Chris out of Kansas City. Scheffler, who's been quiet. Donald had the shot.
They're switching now. They're tired and confused defensively. Lee Coward had Gottfried. Now he switches back. Oh, my goodness.
Another air ball.
Got to catch the 10.
Ford on the break. Finds Coward. Got two.
Very good, that open floor. Responds, usually with the right decision.
Gottfried, boy, he gets in the block.
A little pick away, right, by Jewell. And Button was right there. Great hustle by Mack.
Finds Schreffler. Schreffler for three. Mack trying to fight for the rebound and keep it alive. Tipped out of bounds, though, Missouri ball.
Does he play his backside off?
Interesting to see Schreffler pull up on the break and miss a three, and he turned and looked at the bench, and Jimmy Cruz gave him the old thumbs up, so that's all right.
Yeah. He could make them. 50% from three last year.
Schreffler out on Coward. Here, ready to create. Now takes the jumper as another air ball. Must have a half dozen air balls in this first half. Button throws up a bird. Heller to follow. That's not going to go. Rebound Donald.
Do they remind you of North Carolina?
Yes.
In the first half, very tough. Doing some things right, not converting them.
Shooting percentages are... I wouldn't be lucky to stay in the 40s the way they're going now.
If you're the assistant in charge of field goal percentage, you better watch it at halftime.
Jewell doesn't really look to shoot it. Sets a mean screen, though. Finds Gottfried again in this spot. Now back to Jewell. Doesn't really want to put it on the floor, really.
Yeah, a little too much. He almost had dribbled himself to an open jumper. But you like your big guys. Pass and go get somebody.
Coming up at halftime, top 20 and other scores. A little interview with Dean Smith as he talked with Philly earlier about the win over James Madison. First half recap. Stick around at the half as we will update you on a busy day in college basketball. Chris Fowler standing by. Missouri by three, looking to take it down. Shot clock is off.
I know I'm sure it's got to feel comfortable, Michael. They're not really playing that well. They're right there.
He's played everybody, too.
Yeah, they're all got a taste of it.
And if you're on Jimmy Cruz's side, you got to feel, hey, we're not hitting our threes. Schreffler has yet to get anything cranked up, hasn't scored a point. McIntyre, the hot hand early. Late, too.
That was a great pull-up.
14 for John McIntyre and a quick timeout as Evansville is going to look to try to score here. John McIntyre has really had himself a half.
Jimmy Cruz looking dumbfounded at Chris Mack for that timeout.
McIntyre averaged not a whole lot last year, really didn't get to play all that much or shoot the ball that much. He's having himself a game, though. And you see the Missouri fans who are out here in force to support their club. And again, we mentioned earlier, but it's one of those stories you like to talk about a lot. Norm Stewart back on the bench again this year. And as you said, Bill, just if you can judge off seeing a guy a couple of days, I mean, there's like a permanent smile on his face as he walks around.
He's delighted. It's like a breath of fresh air. Start renew the renaissance of Norm Stewart. Red Holzman told me years ago he was a heck of a basketball player and baseball player. Little NBA time, and you know, has that tough veneer, that facade.
Well, one of those guys who, you know, one of those coaches who you see on TV and you say, oh, I don't know if I want to go out to lunch with him. But boy, off the court, he's delightful.
Yeah, he's charming, and he's had so much success down there. And bouncing back with a pretty good basketball team takes a lot of pressure off you, doesn't it?
That helps. That sure helps. All right, let's see what Evansville can do. They got 4 seconds, down five, 30 to 25 here, first half. Took about four plays off in the Carolina game during this time. Streffler lets it fly. It will not go, and it'll be a five-point game at halftime. So the Missouri Tigers not happy with their shooting percentages, but they got a lead. Jim Crews takes his club to the locker room. We go to Chris Fowler in studio.
Okay, thanks, fellas. So a rusty first half for both clubs. Missouri has a five-point lead. Now, you heard the fellas talking about the game earlier tonight on ESPN from the Maui Classic. North Carolina and James Madison, Dean Smith against Lethrew Dizelle. Safe to say it's the best finish of any game so far this year in college basketball. We started out with the wave out in Maui. Lefty's club looked good early, a 24-5 run. Kenny Brooks at the end of the first half off glass. James Madison by nine on intermission. They kept it going early second half. Steve Hood, hot all night from three-point land. 32 points to lead all scorers for Hood. Back Carolina came though, 47 seconds, down by seven, and Hubert Davis buries the three-pointer, cuts the lead to four. 12 seconds left. Pete Chilcutt, not known as a three-point shooter, buries it. Carolina down by just four. William Davis almost gets a turnover, comes down out of bounds. Carolina still down by a point with 4 seconds left. Mike Gorman picks it up.
Look and finds Rice. Three, two, one. Leaner goes at the buzzer. Basket counts. North Carolina's won it.
80 to 79 is the final. Kevin Madden had 19, Rick Fox 18, and King Rice 13 points and the game winner. Bill Raftery talked with Dean Smith after the game.
Well, we were lucky at the end, the last 8 seconds, but before then we had several opportunities, I thought, Billy, to win the game. Coach Fox was through for a layup, and everything is falling into place, but I didn't have a timeout, and in late game situations, we haven't worked on like we will later on, so what we're trying to do is have Fox make that drive, but King made it.
Carolina moves on to the semifinals. So does Louisville, 89-70 over Chaminade. Everick Sullivan, 35 points, more than doubling his career high. 16 of 22 from the floor. Cardinals 17 offensive rebounds as they pound Chaminade for the first time ever. Now Villanova advanced, beating San Diego State. They will take on North Carolina in the next round. Tom Grice had 14 points. Aaron Bain 11 points in his debut. We have a lot more scores and some highlights coming up as we continue at halftime. The Maui Classic, Missouri and Evansville. The Tigers have a five-point lead.
Who's pulling away in advanced 4x4 technology, Chevy S10 Blazer or Ford Bronco 2? Chevy pulls away in power with the biggest V6 engine in its class. Chevy pulls away with Instatrack, America's favorite four-wheel drive system. Chevy pulls away in fun with the country's number one sport utility vehicle. When it comes to today's 4x4s, it's Chevy S10 Blazer, clean and simple. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Today's truck is Chevrolet.
He who brings me the kingdom's most valuable object shall marry my daughter.
Sire, I slay two dragons for the kingdom's most valuable object.
Next.
I swam crocodile-infested waters for this.
Next.
Sire, I didn't slay any dragons, but look, a Sony Trinitron XBR. XBR, incredible picture, amazing SRS stereo sound. Nothing's more valuable.
Bingo.
The Sony Trinitron XBR TV. Every castle should have one.
What's it like to be in Magic Johnson's shoes? It's seeing 19,000 people scream and not hearing a sound. It's the pain and the anger of the foul melting away until you're left standing, one on one. Just you and the hoop. And you feel it from the top of your head right down to the soles of your cons.
Call now and you can have 13 weeks of the Wall Street Journal and this valuable 120-page guide to understanding money and markets. That's 13 weeks of the journal for the news and ideas you need every business day. And this guide free, which tells you everything you want to know about money and markets, now for only $34. Call toll-free 800-554-9000. Today's Wall Street Journal. Faster, tougher, smarter. Call 800-554-9000 now.
ESPN's coverage of the 1989 Maui Classic is brought to you by Today's Chevrolet, who invites you to see why nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. And by Coast to Coast Total Hardware and Coast to Coast Home and Auto Stores. A lot of scores from the early season tournaments to update you on. We start with the Dodge NIT, the championship game tonight in Madison Square Garden. Kansas coming off wins over LSU and UNLV, taking on number 25 St. John's. Kansas just keeps doing it. Mark Randall, the center out of Denver, takes the pass from Pritchard, banks it in. Randall hustling all night with the follow. 17 points in the first half. The Jayhawks led by 13. Red Denver led by Boo Harvey, meanwhile. Harvey with a three-pointer. At a career-high 28 points, Kansas lead cut to six. More Boo. The dish is off right there. Billy Singleton. And we're tied at 55 as Roy Williams is concerned. Shouldn't have worried. Jeff Geltner hits the three-pointer. Kansas takes the lead for good. They run out the clock, and a happy Kansas team wins the Dodge NIT Championship 66-57. Mark Randall, 25 points and 10 rebounds. And Malik Seeley had 15. Boo Harvey, 28 for St. John's. UNLV in the consolation game, looking a lot more like the number one team they did the other night. 88-53. Larry Johnson had 32 points. To the Great Alaska Shootout now. Texas A&M beating UConn 92-81. Lynn Suber, 33 points. 7 of 8 three-pointers. Michigan State over Auburn, 92-79, also up in Alaska. Kansas State trailing Florida State in the second half by 7, 65-58. Memphis State, number 24, over Tennessee State, 99-74. Tennessee over Austin Peay, a close one, 71-69. Clemson over the American College of Puerto Rico, 87-73. Ricky Jones had 13 points. Stetson over Bradley at the San Juan Shootout also, 74-67. Maurice Cowan had 20 points. Eastern Michigan upsetting Wisconsin 71-52 down in San Juan. They'll play Alabama the next round because Alabama beat Western Kentucky 79-72. Keith Askins had 18 points. In the Century Salinette Classic, Mississippi State over Northeast Louisiana 75-68. Also Centenary over Baylor 89-87. First win for Tommy Vardman in his rookie season. Bowling Green over Jacksonville 87-75. New Hampshire clobbered by Providence. Expect that, 72-49. In the Investors Classic, Marshall over Army, 81-74. John Taft had 32 points. Also in the Investors Classic, Virginia over Northeastern, 82-60. The first meeting ever between those two teams. We'll continue from halftime. Our college basketball studios here. Halftime of the Maui Classic. In the meantime, a look at more college basketball scores from this evening.
People hold on to their cars for a long time. There's a guy here in town that bought a car from us 14 years ago, and we've been doing the service work for him all that time. Well, he came in the other day and bought another new car. I suppose he'll keep this one for a long time too, but he told me he bought it Dimple Wolf because of our service department. Now he's a happy customer. If he's happy, we're happy. We can make you happy too. Dimple Wolf Ford Lincoln Mercury in Henderson. Our people do make the difference.
Make the Factory Direct Showroom your one-stop Christmas gift shop. Over 8,000 square feet of quality merchandise is here for your shopping convenience, and all at Factory Direct prices. Choose from our selection of beautiful solid oak furnishings for every room in your home. A pool table and accessories would fill your leisure hours with fun. Or buy a little springtime for the golf enthusiast. You'll find it only at the Factory Direct Showroom, 5310 Boonville Highway, one block east of Green River Road. Open daily through December 30th.
And he gave up.
This time, he won't get the chance.
When two legends come together.
Le gané una vez y le voy a ganar de nuevo.
From different worlds.
This time, you better come to fight.
Talk is cheap.
Lo voy a mandar a la lona para siempre.
When the bell sounds December 7th, the truth will be told and actions will speak louder than words. Uno Mas, the deciding battle between Sugar Ray Leonard and Roberto Duran at the Mirage, Las Vegas.
And now, Budweiser presents the main event.
For over 50 years, Jaguar has built classic motor cars that represent good value for the money. Nowhere is this more apparent than in the 1990 Jaguar XJ6. It has a more powerful engine, a new transmission, and other significant improvements. So while we haven't lowered our standards, at $39,700, we've made it easier for you to raise yours. Jaguar, a blending of art and machine. For the name of your nearest Jaguar dealer, call toll-free.
We'll go from the tropics to the frozen tundra approximately 1:30 a.m. Eastern Time. We're Alaska Shootout, Hawaii, and Alaska Anchorage. Now back to the cozy confines of the Lahaina Civic Center for our second half of this ball game. Mike Gorman and Bill Raftery.
Okay. Welcome back to Maui, everyone. There's the halftime score, 30-25. Missouri, the 5-point lead over Evansville. And you know, the type of game, Bill, where coaches haven't got a lot to complain about, and the guys are running the plays well, but nothing's going in.
Well, you're sitting there saying, gee, we're really running some nice stuff, and we just can't complete the sequence. And I think it's been a problem. The bumps have been good. The design of the offense has been good. But when a guy like Godfrey gives you a screen, you've got to make the basket. And right here, you can see down on that box, the big guy, Dan Godfrey, does a great job freeing Mark Jewell. And it's been tough for Jimmy Cruz.
And John McIntyre on the other end has a career high in the first half.
Well, I saw them last year, and he always looked good. He was like a 12 o'clock kicker. The game had started, he wouldn't be able to maybe make the goal because he didn't have the confidence of staying on the floor. You can see there that ability to dribble was all set up by his outside shooting, Michael. He's got a great touch, and now he's got the four between. No man's land.
Yeah, a couple of the names we really thought would be stickouts here. Anthony Beeler for one, Scott Schreffler for another. Really have not been factors in this game at all. And you wonder, both coaches got to see 9, 10, 11 players. Did they kind of settle into what they want in the second half?
And defensively, now we're getting Chris Mack, obviously a good picker as well, with the big guys. And anytime you screen, you set people up. And Beeler was really caught. He was indecisive. And sometimes that happens because you're not shooting well. You don't concentrate on the other end because you're not into your flow.
And here's Anthony Beeler again, a player we thought could really light it up. And Anthony just unable to find any kind of rhythm. And that may be one of what a half dozen, to be conservative, air balls we saw in that first.
We may have seen a career record for these kids shooting the ball. Somebody must be moving the glass. Again, they've got to relax. First game, get the jitters out of their system.
Okay, we will be back with second half action. Final game from Maui coming up. Just a minute.
My Maui is the cool green of upcountry. It's my first sight of the humpback each November. It's the protea and heliconia. It's the face of another planet.
My Maui, it's me!
Maui, come for the beauty, stay for the people.
Coast to coast, home and out of doors.
At Coast to Coast, we really know our customers, and our customers know us. We're friends.
Save during our Christmas sale on Hoover's Elite Upright Vacuum with five-piece tool set, only $79.99. Buy the Dustbuster Cordless Hand Vac, only $22.88. Or Black & Decker's Handy Chop Mincer Chopper, only $19.99. At your local Coast to Coast and Home and Auto store.
Coast to Coast, Home and Auto.
We'll get the next one.
Hey, what is that?
It's a Compact SLT 286. Every broker in our firm has one. You know how important the right information is to these guys. We never had it on the old system. I called MicroAge. They showed us how compact computers can work for us here and on the road. Powerful portables and desktops that can crunch numbers with the best of them. I make sure that every broker's got a compact.
Good decision.
Secret to success?
MicroAge, authorized compact dealer.
A while back, John Barricado went car shopping.
Take a couple of these, three
of those. He bought 10.
Any particular color, sir?
Nah.
Then he did something really unusual.
Ready?
Ready!
You see, John leads the arson team at Aetna, the company leading the fight against one of America's most expensive crimes. And if we can learn something, we don't mind burning a little cash today.
This is what you look for.
To save customers a bundle down the road.
We're gonna need more cars.
ESPN's coverage of the 1989 Maui Classic is brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Aged, the clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By Energizer Batteries, nothing outlasts the Energizer. And by the U.S. Armed Forces, where opportunity is waiting for you.
We're back at Maui, second half about to begin here, 30-25. A quick look at the halftime numbers. The shooting percentages didn't get to the 30s, but they got real close, as you can see. That comes out to about 41% for Missouri, 40% for Evansville. Everything else pretty even on down the board. Nobody with any big advantage. Just again, somebody's going to start putting the ball in the hole, and the other guy better catch up if they do.
And your point of stamina, Norm Stewart playing his bench and everybody getting a feel for it, that could be the deciding factor in the next 20 minutes.
The big names, though, just invisible in this game. Doug Smith, no points, two rebounds. But Godfrey's had a good game and continues to have one.
That's too simple to get free. That's lazy defense by Missouri. Screen away, man wide open. You either have to slide it or switch it strong.
13 for Godfrey. McIntyre finds Smith. It's blocked. Bunton, rather. Godfrey right there, and he's there again.
Nathan didn't like that lack composure there. He should have just kicked it out, reset.
Godfrey again is 11th in the country in blocked shots. Couldn't control that one down the low post. Wanted it. See the look on Jim Cruz's face.
Same play. Jimmy Cruz has found a very simple way of getting the ball to the box.
Smith calling for it. Gets it over Jewell. Big basket there, and then it might get Doug Smith off the mark. 5-point Missouri lead just underway, second half. Godfrey again, turn around the other way. In and out, Smith is there. Coward, the quick push to Peeler. Shut off by Mack. They go to Smith, he's immediately double-teamed.
Leaving McIntyre alone, I don't know. Good reaction.
Oh,
by
good hands by Mack.
Chris Mack all over, helped on the box.
Schreffler, the guy that Jimmy Cruz would like to see get one in there and maybe get his confidence up. Mack nowhere to go. Jewell down low, Godfrey, couple of fakes. Too hard, and again, Doug Smith ripping off a rebound.
Pretty good help defensively by Missouri. Much more active on that particular play. Good help side.
Jewell picks up a foul, his second, and Doug Smith has been more active in the first minute 45 of the second half than he was in the entire first half.
Well, maybe Norm got his attention.
He said John McIntyre was having himself a heck of a game, a career high in that first half, and a drop off to Coward and Peeler. Smith already improving on those numbers. McIntyre. Warren, the good job in the offensive boy, but look at Jewell come for the reject. Peeler, Smith for two.
Great pass by Peeler.
Seven-point Missouri lead. Hill down low. Hill tries to create, won't go down. Oof, Warren went down hard, and it traveled.
It's got to be a walk, Mike. Another thing you can argue about. Hill, excellent. We just couldn't come up. Again, once Missouri reacts inside here, you see all the help. They're going to be much better for it, doing more of it. Anytime you fall to the floor or get up from the floor with the ball, it's called a one.
Jewell will inbound. Howard staying in touch with Schreffler. Acker's looking inside, wants to find Godfrey. Mack leaves it. Offensive foul. Chris Mack going down the lane, his second.
I thought that was a play on, Michael. Just let him slide by. Keep the players going up and down. Jimmy Cruz, great control of his emotions.
McIntyre waves Coward away.
Much more active inside with their screens and rotations offensively. Bucksmith outside now after going across the box.
Nails the jumper.
He was sort of flat-footed, standing, begging. Now he's got some mobility.
Six here, 3 minutes of the second half for Doug Smith. Biggest lead of the night for Missouri.
They've done a great job on Schreffler, haven't they?
Yes, they have. Can't get a shot off. And turnover is something the Purple Aces cannot afford right now.
Jeff Warren really leaned and got the weight back. Caused the errant pass. Good defense.
Milt Donald in and Jewell out. Jimmy Cruz trying to get a quicker club on the floor.
Nice play by Chris Mack. Got a hand on it. Double tick.
Mack is active.
The old t-shirts. Remember LaSalle with Tom Golo? That's going way back before your time, I'm sure.
Providence College for a long time used to wear them.
Lenny Wilkins wore them, if I'm not mistaken. In his era.
Johnny Schreffler won't go for him. And the rebounding foul. I think it's going to be Brian Hill picking it up. If it is, it's the third.
You got to ring the bell. And right now, Jimmy Cruz having their problems.
Travis Ford's going to come back in. John McIntyre will sit down for Missouri. 9-point lead, the biggest of the night for either side, as Ford now, the freshman from Kentucky, will run the offense. Peeler still very quiet in this game. Smith. Immediately double. Boy, Mack gets down there quickly on the double.
Nice pass.
Warren rejected by Godfrey out of bounds.
You can always tell a kid likes to pass when he snaps that ball on that angle right across the lane. Nobody can get their hand up.
15:52 to go in the game. Missouri kind of gaining control here, up by 9.
To you by the King of Beers.
Now, almost every time you use MasterCard before December 31st, you increase your chances of winning your MasterCard bills paid up to $18,000 a year till the 21st century. MasterCard. Master the moment until the 21st century.
The Volvo 240 has built a reputation for surviving accidents, and we at Subaru have always been impressed by that. So we gave the new Subaru Legacy Wagon unibody construction, like the Volvo 240. But unlike the 240, the Subaru Legacy is available with full-time four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes. Because the best way to survive an accident is not to get into one.
To make wrenching fast and easy, you can either do this, or get this, the Skill Wrench Cordless Power Wrench. It's revolutionary.
Now, Michael, defense is a strong suit of the Evansville Purple Aces, and Dan Godfrey in position here, gets one on Button, gets another, but the Nudge right down there, too. Chris Mack always in the middle of things, just nudging around, creating havoc. And Mr. Indiana, when he was younger, Mark Jewell anticipating beautifully, but the poise, you mentioned Peeler not playing well here, running it down. Great dish to finish by Smith, the All-American.
Smith the inbound, he finds Warren. Missouri the ball in the 9-point lead.
Oh,
good for two.
Lee Coward, that's been worked on. Step up, and then a nice roll to the goal by Doug Smith.
Doug Smith with 8 points here in the second half, all eight of Missouri's points. Schreffler trying to get loose, and finally knocks one down.
That up, baby. Like to see all of them shoot well, wouldn't you? Both clubs struggling from the floor. I just think so early in the year, not finely tuned.
Smith got hit on the arm by Hill, number four. It's going to bring Larry Brand off the bench for the first time tonight for Evansville. Hill has been active out there, stops to get a word or two from Jim Cruz. And at the line, Doug Smith. Again, a table full of pro scouts at one end, and this is one of the kids they really got their eye on.
Well, when you think of Evansville, at least I do, think of the capes that Aaron McCutcheon used to wear. And he was an innovator. He used to keep them warm, yet they were ready to play. They didn't have the snap-off pants in those days.
And here's Peeler off the missed free throw.
Got to be alert. And of course, Aaron, great coaching career, Hall of Famer.
Inside, Godfrey kicks it back out to Donald.
Oh, Smith, great reaction.
Mack looking to find some room, does, gets it.
They're going to have to really run their stuff perfectly now to overcome their poor shooting. They just try and get Missouri gambling a little bit.
Ford had a three. Lee Coward, little room. Great boxing out there.
Pretty well, the triangle. Lee Coward almost got that passing lane.
Pretty inside, Godfrey, sent back at him. Foul is called, but that'll give you an indication of how Anthony Peeler can get up.
Anthony has been known to electrify people. Another excellent pass on the baseline side, defense on the high side, and Dan, how sweet it is. Oh, huh. And Bill is saying to Doug Smith, what are you doing? I just bailed you out.
Godfrey steps to the line, his club down nine with 14 minutes to go in the game. Dan Godfrey 11 points tonight, I make it 13 tonight. Six block shots. Again, 11th in the country last year in block shots.
Nick Paparo calming things down. Godfrey must have landed on Smith's foot, or Peeler did, because he went after Anthony Peeler.
The last thing Norm Stewart needs is his own guys going at each other. Jimmy Cruz with a few words for the referees. Godfrey will eventually get a couple here once Dick Paparo has talked to everyone on the floor.
Norm sitting over saying, boy, Goff looked pretty good. Relaxed all summer, now he's back at it. Norm's got two good point guards on the floor now. And that really should help him get the ball to the right spot. Their offense has opened up a little bit. When you got Coward and Ford able to see things and really look for others first.
Peeler unable to shake himself loose on the wing. Now he comes through in the baseline. They're looking for him, but Donald did a good job staying with him. Doug Smith wants it. Comes up short. There's Mack again. Mack rebounds. He shoots it. He double teams.
Omnipresent.
Schreffler just lost the handle as he tried to set himself to shoot. Thinking about it a little bit.
Just don't forget the perspiration, too.
Yes.
Ball is slippery.
No question. Peeler outside, knocks it down for three.
Now that should help his game a little bit. Honing in with the jumper.
Back to a 10-point lead. Milt Donald.
They can't say enough for Lee Coward. He's going to get the foul here, but he has been tagging Scott Schreffler.
Yep.
He hasn't been alone for a moment.
Stewart uses this break to get about two or three of his players around him. They've got a quick little conference.
Both guys using it as a free timeout.
Yep. Warren and Ford just able to get back in the play. Mack right into Godfrey. Brand will try one. Rebound to Lee Cowers.
He could have gotten his own rebound.
He watched it.
Yeah, you know when you shoot it, whether you're going to make it or not.
Travis Ford. Warren keeping it alive, working hard on the board. Doesn't get it down, though, and that'll be Doug Smith over the back of Mack. Number three on Doug Smith.
That's what happens when you don't complete a sequence. Ball keeps alive, and all of a sudden, Doug Smith, somewhat frustrated, but Mack just gets his body on you, causes problems. Number 34, both on the shirt and on the head.
Godfrey and Smith doing battle. On the other end, a miss is pulled down by Peeler. Anthony Peeler, a little room.
Got it in. With the right hand as well, Michael. That's tough for lefties.
Peeler now in double figures with 11, seven of those here in the second half as he and Doug Smith have both come alive.
Awaken.
12-point Missouri lead. Schreffler lines one up, off to the left. Doug Smith the rebound.
And Lee Coward just right there. I mean, he has played such great defense.
Want to go inside to Smith, who faked going baseline and came back. Might have had a shot at the ball. Here's Smith. Kicks it out, Peeler. A rebound down there from Mack again.
Mack looks like a little bit like Pete Rose. Huh? Dirty pants, blood. They're going to throw that uniform away when he's finished.
He sure is involved. Here he comes top of the key. Smith got a hand in there. Crowd wanted a call. Godfrey will get the bucket.
Excellent post pass. And they're very well schooled, proficient in that area.
17 for Dan Godfrey, who leads all scorers. But it's Missouri by 10. We approach the halfway mark here in the second half. Smith trying to shovel. Good catch by Coward.
Yeah, not a real good pass, though, no. Was it, Mike?
I'd rather say good catch by Coward.
You're protecting him.
Warren lost the handle, but it comes right back to Peeler. 14 on the shot clock. Coward to Warren. Warren for two.
Great play. Warren reacting very well, too, coming down the lane. Lee Coward always plays within himself.
Godfrey again. Boy, I tell you, that's there all night, Bill.
Well, Warren is denying on the top side. What he has to do, if he can't get a piece of the ball, slide down and stay between the man and the basket. He's just turning him to the hole.
Warren gave the little screen. Smith couldn't kiss it off the glass. Here comes Donald, and the Purple Aces can get back to eight. Chris Mack for three.
Harsh. Evansville doesn't score those quick goals. You're going to have to make sure they run their offense, take advantage of each sequence.
Godfrey. couple of fakes, picked up the foul.
Well, he knows those inside post moves.
That's a pretty good little Kevin McHale imitation he gave right there, wasn't it?
Not the long gangly arms and legs, but same idea.
Wholesale substitutions here as Missouri goes to their bench and brings in a bunch. We'll check it for you. Here's a replay.
Jimmy Cruz really had a disadvantage with the wholesale subs, but they really do get the ball to the critical spots. You can see how well schooled they are with the feet work, footwork. Nice step across and just a bump. He was actually, that was a left-handed hook shot is what he should have gone for, but once he got the body, just wanted to make sure he went to the free throw line.
Bunton, Sutton, both have come in along with McIntyre. Ford and Peeler stay on the floor for Missouri. Point of the night for Dan Gottfried. We'll have a break with 9 minutes to go. Missouri by 10.
Join the U.S. Armed Forces. You're in with top quality people and top quality experiences.
Opportunity is waiting for you. In the U.S. Armed Forces, you're in.
Imagine a world beneath the sea with an enchanted McDonald's of pure fantasy, where the Little Mermaid's friend Sebastian and Flounder the fish come to life to grant your holiday wish.
Buy a $5 book of McDonald's gift certificates and get a free plush ornament, either Flounder or Sebastian.
I always knew I'd be famous.
From the all-new Disney animated feature, The Little Mermaid, now in theaters everywhere.
So come to McDonald's, hurry along. Like a true fantasy, it's here then, it's gone.
Your holiday place, McDonald's.
For years, we've been telling you how the four-wheel drive Subaru helps the U.S. ski team get to their events early. Yet at the 1989 World Championships, the U.S. team was not the first to arrive. The Norwegians beat us, the French beat us, as did the Italians and the Swedes. How'd they do it? That was the year we lent them all a Subaru.
Missouri's lead is 9 with 9:01 to go here. Final game of the day from the Maui Classic. First round action. Chris Mack is just all over the floor for Evansville.
Well, competition takes all forms. Peeler had blocked the shot earlier, and Mack was saying, we got to the free throw line. I mean, he gives all he has to Jimmy Cruz at Evansville. Great competitor.
Turnovers even at 8. And Missouri taking a little bit of advantage of it. Chaka Chandler is seeing his first action tonight for Evansville. Loose ball, Warren. Good hustle, but he hit the line. That's giving it up, though.
So shortly after that roofing by Chris Mack, Anthony Peeler started to play a little bit better, so leave a sleeping performer on the couch.
Chandler just in the ball game number 5. Jimmy Cruz searching for a hot hand.
A lot of fresh bodies by Norm Stewart. Just continuing, starting the first half.
Brand outside, hits that one. Larry Brand, his first 2 of the night. 7-point Missouri lead. McIntyre. Bunt kicks it over to Ford. Good fake. Squares up. Won't go down for him.
He's had his shots, too.
Evansville a chance to get to 5 here. Brand again. Back rims, this one comes to Bunton, who boxed out.
Pretty good rotation on his shot. Then Gottfried continues to get good position in the post area, and Missouri is on the high side and not recovering. I'd like to see Evansville dump it down to him.
comes to McIntyre. Chandler out on him. Big button. Bunting again. Daughtry not going for any of the fakes, staying home.
Pretty good position defense.
Peeler in traffic. Picks up a foul on the drive.
I think that might be a Milt Donald, although Gottfried got over there helping out.
Good call, second on Donald. Here's Doug Smith. And yes, if you're trying to look closely, that is his number that has been shaved into the back of his head.
Peeler has been quiet, though.
Missouri's only been at the line four times in this game.
Anthony's played well this half, possesses a lot of talent,
and is young. In fact, he'll turn 20 tomorrow.
And a new team, too. I mean, Byron Irvin gone, Leonard the center guy. It's a different type of team, so it takes a while to blend and to get a feel for one another.
Chandler comes down with a missed second free throw. The lead is eight. Missouri's got it. Evansville's got the ball. Mack really wanted that all the way down the court.
And Mack took Button down on the other end. He gets away with a little bit, doesn't he?
And looking inside, Godfrey wanted it. They come this way again. They go into Godfrey. Kicks it out. Chandler will try, and he knocks down the jumper.
Much better job by Nathan Bundy. Stayed at home. Godfrey couldn't make that move.
It's six as Evansville continues to just creep closer. Smith down low. No. Second one. No. Godfrey the rebound. Evansville can get to four. Crowd, especially the neutral part of it. Brand got two, very much behind the Purple Aces right now, 48-44.
Missouri asleep defensively. They didn't match up, get their assignments. Norm Stewart, of course, a little bit upset, but he has some fresh people to put in.
5:53 to go in the game, and it's a game. 4-point Missouri lead.
I'll never forget 1958. The first overtime championship game ever played in the NFL. Unitas and the Colts, they beat the Giants 23-17.
And the sporting news was there.
Hey, you want overtime? How about that 1982 playoff game? The Chargers over the Dolphins, 41-38. The most exciting game I ever saw.
And the sporting news was there. Yes, whether it's football, baseball, basketball, or hockey, wherever the excitement is, the sporting news is there, bringing you more complete coverage than any other sports weekly. Call now for the sporting news at the lowest price anywhere, with convenient delivery right to your door.
Call 1-800-782-5700 and get 29 issues of the Sporting News for four payments of just $4.99. You'll save 69% off the cover price, 40% off the regular subscription rate. You can't get a better deal. Call now 1-800-782-5700. That's 1-800-782-5700.
The Tennessee Volunteers need a victory against Kentucky to keep their hopes alive for a share of the SEC title. It's College Football Saturday at 3:30 Eastern, live on ESPN. The Saints continue their playoff march. The Rams will be fired up in this battle for a wild card spot. Mike Patrick and Joe Theismann bring you Sunday Night NFL at 8 Eastern, live on ESPN.
Lots of Evansville fans made the trip out here to Maui, 48-44. Four-point game, and a quick way to sum it up here as we take a look at the storyline from tonight's game. As the Purple Aces hustle back out on the floor.
Well, they've been doing that all night.
That's pretty much the storyline, yeah. All right, Travis Ford and Lee Coward to run the show from Missouri. Ford, plenty of room, thinks about it and buries it.
There's no question he can do it.
He was a little upset at his inability to make it. He had to be coaxed into that one.
The lead is 6-50-44. Down low, there's Gottfried again in his 22nd point of the night.
Wendell Normstor looks at his defense. He has to be disgusted. Post-play defense has been inept.
Ford again. Tracked down by Mack. Evansville can get to two. Brand inside, threw it away.
And Nathan Button with terrific defense that time. He had switched from